All right, now we will do the same for analog output, but in this case we are going to feed the voltage from the HMI. That's the task. So how we can do that? If you see in this HMI object, wait a second, I will remove this video. In this HMI object, in the default, in the symbols, you will see a slider. So I will take a slider horizontal, so drag it here. So using the slider, you can also do it by a pneumatic input, but I use a slider to give the voltage to my analog output. Okay, so I take the slider here and I will write the text. I will copy this text from here. This is my out one, my first channel. Okay, and in this case I also want the scale to represent 0 to 10 volts. You can do anything you want, but for this example I use 0 to 10 volts. So scale output maximum is 10. Oops. It's 10. Check interval similarly 1. And if you really like, you can also change the color of this. So maybe I change the line color a bit. This is the line color for the marking, font color and the fill color. Okay, I prefer this one. And maybe I will change thumbnail rectangle. Okay, this is this one. I will make it like this. Okay, so this is my 0 to 10 scale, and similar to analog input, we will also change its dynamic scale. Where is that? It should be in the settings. Thumb dynamic path. So high range will be 30,000 again. Okay, so now our settings are defined, 0 to 10 volts, scaling of 0 to 30,000, and parameters and the variable. So let's come to the variable after we do some changes in the PLC programming. So I'm going to come to this main logic. This is analog IOs, and this was for input, or I can put input. Copy paste. I will type input. So this is my input. Bring these guys down a little bit. And similarly, we make an output. I will do it here. Okay, now what is the step? We are going to move the value from the HMI. Okay, so that's my input going to the PLC. So in this case, let's go to the variable and we take analog out 01, which is coming from my HMI. Okay, this is coming in dint. Let's take dint external and I go back to my PLC. And I take this as an HMI tag, analog out 01, make a tag, analog out 01. Now this tag should be linked here, analog out 01. So this is going to give me the value from 0 to 30,000, okay, to my PLC tag, analog 01, out 01. So I come back here, and oh, wait a second, I need to check something. We already have, okay, we have this tag analog 01, which is linked. If you remember, this tag is linked to your IOs, analog IOs. So this output 01, this tag is linked to your analog, physical analog, oh, sorry, not this one, this one. Physical analog output, out 01. This is where the voltage is going to be generated using this tag. And from the HMI, the values from 0 to 30,000 are coming here. This is the HMI tag. So we have to move the value from here to your physical IO tag. But this is in digital int. We need to convert that to word. Okay. That's what we're going to do now. So going back to my coding. So I will take convert. Word. So take this one to word, comes here. Now the input. Analog out 1, this is coming from the HMI, and the output will be out 01. This is out 01, which is going to the physical I/O. Okay, that's it. That's how we are moving the value from HMI to the word and giving the voltage. Okay, if you also want to show the value on the HMI, we can also do that. So in this case, we convert this out 01 to real and then divide by 3000, and we can get a scaled output. We can do that very quickly. So I will first take another temporary variable because we have to work with the real. So I will type temp 02. This should be real, also local. Go back to code. Now I will copy this one to real. And input will be this one. Copy, paste. I hope I can also connect. Let me try. Parallel. Yeah, that's better. So this will convert to real and we get an output in temp 02. That's the real. Now we divide this and get the scaling. So I will copy this guy here, divide temp 02 divided by 300. Okay, you have to come down, give some space for these guys. And now the output, I need another variable. Like I have this one, I will type analog out 01 scaled. This is real external and we need an HMI tag for that. So first of all, define it here. Analog out 01 scaled. It's defined here. Now I go back here. Analog out 01 scaled. I will make an HMI tag. So this is the scaled value. This is coming from the HMI and this is the scaled value. So I go back to my page again. So this value is getting inside the PLC, getting it scaled and then coming out. So I will copy this variable, bring it here, change the variable in the dynamics, analog out scaled. That's it. Press enter. So this is defined here. Now let's just bring it to the top and let's try to download. Okay, so this is getting download and I can show you my camera. So you can see the analog output is connected to my multimeter already. So we can see the values here. Looks like this is downloaded. Now I will launch the simulator. Login. Okay, so right now it's 00. I move it to 3 and I see 3 volts. And why do I see 30 here? I need to check again. Did I do some mistake? Oh, it should be 3000. Same mistake. Okay, let me just quickly correct this. I have a habit of doing things in percentage. Maybe that's what's going in my brain. So let me check to 3000. Right, and start project. And starting the simulator. Oh, still writing. Okay, launch simulator. All right, now we can see if I move the slider, we have some values in our multimeter. You can see it's coming in voltage, 4.33 volts, 6 volts approximately, and up to 10 volts. So that's how you can give the voltage from the HMI to your analog audio device directly. Okay, and you can show the scales value here. So analog input is coming here. Okay, and also change it 3.58, and output is shown on the multimeter. All right, so this is about how to display analog IOs in your HMI and do some little bit of scaling if you like. And now in the next, maybe in the next video, I will show you, this is also a quite big video, I will show you how to display this HMI screen, not in the software, but in a browser. So you can connect to this, you can connect to this PLC NICed via Ethernet cable, and then you can connect this cable to your computer, open the browser, and you can view the results. Or you can connect this PLC NICed to a Wi-Fi access point, and then connect your phone and connect to this PLC via Wi-Fi, and you can see your HMI screen. So whatever way you can do that, you just need an Ethernet connection. All right, so let's see that in the next video.